tonight. And then you go back in your room.
There are over 7 million mentally ill and emotionally disturbed children in America. This program is about some of those children and the institutions they live in. Children of Darkness, next on Nonfiction Television. This program is made possible by a grant from the Independent Documentary Fund, which is supported by the National Endowment for the Arts, the Ford Foundation, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and public television stations, with additional funding from the following. This program contains language and sequences some viewers may find disturbing.
His name is Brian. Along with 16 other mentally ill children, he's on a bus trip to the zoo. Brian believes that somebody is following him.
A truck's following us. That guy back there is driving me crazy. Oh, God, they dropped in. Oh, God. Oh, now, Wax, you better stop that truck. Now, Wax, you better stop that truck. Don't go off the bus! It's gonna kill my motherfucking dog, my dad! I'm gonna kill you!
Brian suffers from mania and schizophrenia. He's been this way since he was 4 years old. Brian lives here at Eastern State School and Hospital in Trevose, Pennsylvania. 160 children live with him. They're psychotic, schizophrenic. They suffer from organic brain damage and autism. Some are hyperactive, some totally withdrawn. Some are suicidal.
I was trying to kill myself so I could be with my mother. That may be hard to understand, but I feel as though once you're dead, you'll be able to be with the other people that are also dead. I love her a lot. And I don't even know her, and that's what's so funny. Like, because I was so young when she died, I don't even know what she looks like or anything. But I just wish she was alive. I have an identity problem. My mom died, my father took off on me, and it hurts. It hurts a lot.
When you started cutting at yourself, what was going on inside your head?
I just wanted to die to be with my mom. I didn't care no more. I didn't care about nobody no more.
Are you going to stay alive or are you going to die?
That's a tough question to answer because I don't know. Sometimes I feel like killing myself. Other times I'm happy and I want to live forever.
Jerry's parents are alive, but because of his muscular dystrophy and emotional problems, they didn't want him.
My parents were ashamed to go out because of me. They were ashamed to take me out, you know. It's like I was the black sheep of the family. It's like,
tomorrow's his 2-year anniversary, and his parents just more or less dropped him off here and said, you got him, see you later, and took off.
When my mom brought me here, I seen her. And I ain't seen her since that day. Since that day she brought me in here, I have not seen her. And 3 days after, they took off from Las Vegas and just left me here. And I didn't know for 6 months, because I was trying to come at home, and I got somebody else moved into our house. And 6 months later, they let me a letter saying they were out in Las Vegas. And they enclosed it with a check for $20. And I guess it's about time that I say something to the fact that they don't want me no more, and they never will, and that it's time for me to get out here and make a life for myself, which I plan to do when I leave.
Can you do it?
Yes, I think I can. I think I can.
Many of the children at Eastern are chronically mentally ill. They'll never see what we see, hear what we hear, think in ways we do.
How much sleep you got in there, son?
Brian McAnally has lived at the hospital for the last 4 years.
Oh, it's me. I want to go swim, that's what I want. Oh, wait. Yeah! Praise the Lord, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Everybody's right.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. Thank you. Lord. Praise the Lord.
I want you to lay down, please, no, Brian. No. Come on, I want you to lay down, okay?
Don't get me sweaty.
I'm not going to get you sweaty. I just want you to lay down.
Lay down, Mark.
Because I think you need to relax.
Okay.
You're a little bit upset, okay?
Okay.
All right, I'll be outside the door if you need me, okay?
It's a dentist's office.
It's a dentist's office.
Hi, doctor.
Do you know what's going on with him? What's the matter with him?
You know what's going on?
Not really. Brian is...
It's kind of scary. It's falling, the house is falling down.
Brian's a very psychotic young man, and...
Mark...
So like I said, he was doing really, really well until about a month or so ago, and he started just regressing, going completely the opposite way. It's like he's coming unglued, and he's hallucinating a lot more. He really has no sense of what reality really is. The other night he was in his room crying, and I knocked on the door to open up and said, Brian, what are you crying about? He said, I got hit in the head. And I said, you got hit in the head? Who hit you?
I got hit in the head.
He said, I was looking out the window and the sun hit me in the head. And he was like really upset all night about, you know, looking out the window, getting hit in the head with the sun. And he's having a really rough time. Tomorrow night we have a van ride, all right? And if you're good and if you feel better, maybe we'll take you out on the van ride.
Okay.
All right?
You're
going
to stay back
for me, Brian.
You're not
going to go to the kitchen. Oh, no! You don't have any money, Brian. Brian?
Come on.
That's it. You breathe. That's it.
Come on, lay down on your bed.
All right, come on. Brian, now you're not going to trip this over. Come on.
Well, Brian,
do
you want us to take it out of your room?
No! Come on, I want you to lay down. Come on.
You're getting yourself up.
Thank you.
Okay, sit down.
I'll call you Tank.
I'll be back in a couple minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Don. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Don. It's perfect.
What the hell does it all mean? I mean, you're here tackling kids, holding them to bed, sticking needles in them. Is that psychotherapy? What's going on?
It's the best we got. I'm serious. It's the best that we have. I mean, there are other institutions that, you know, maybe a little bit better, there may be a little bit more staff, but I've worked in enough institutions to know that this is, you know, it's the best system we got, and nobody's come up with a better system yet.
Is everything that's going on upsetting you, Brian?
Yeah, the walls are cracking. Oh my God, look.
Raphael, walk with the group, please.
Eastern State is the largest children's state psychiatric hospital in America. This year's budget is for $13.5 million. That's $84,000 per year per child. For this, each one gets food, medication, and a place to sleep. For those who could benefit from it, there is almost no one-to-one or any other form of psychotherapy. The major therapy at Eastern is drugs. Almost every child there gets some form of psychotropic medication.
I like to go swimming.
Medication that alters the brain's chemistry in an attempt to control psychotic behavior.
Olivia Lakes. Olivia Lakes.
He's a likable boy. He is mildly retarded.
I'm not retarded. Oh, retarded,
well,
right?
In the sense of the word.
Retarded.
Some is due to environmental conditions at home. Brian was a product, I think, of an unplanned pregnancy. He was abandoned by his mother. He's never seen her. You know. Father is very much involved, very loving.
He's coming to
very concerned
outside, right?
As to what his future will be.
Brian! All right, Brian.
I look forward to every Sunday for Brian. It's my day. Sunday is my day.
Sunday's the day Jim McAnally and his son have spent together for the past 4 years. It's the day Brian gets to go home. Most Sundays, Linda Nixon comes along too. She grew up next door to Brian, and he likes to think of her as his girlfriend. Mr. McAnally lost his leg in an automobile accident when he was 19. Now he's 70 years old and has had two serious strokes. When Brian's illness became too much for him to handle, Jim had to give him up to the hospital. But for the first 14 years of Brian's life, Jim raised him in this house in East Philadelphia. During the Depression, Jim earned a living selling bananas, oranges, and strawberries from a horse-drawn wagon. On the streets of Philadelphia, they called him the Huckster.
Brian, sit down a minute. All right, come on. I'm going to do the Huckster for you.
Okay.
All sound, salad, tomatoes, new white potatoes, hardheads, or lettuce, fresh cabbage, string beans, bananas, 3 pounds per quarter. Be right there, lady.
Yeah. Remember Fritz ate your leg off?
Yeah, I remember that, too.
Sure, Fritz. So how Fritz ate your leg off?
No, I was laying on the couch taking a nap.
Yeah.
What's going to happen to Brian when I die? I don't know what's going to happen. Who's going to go take Brian out on Sunday or a Saturday? Who's going to bring him home for the holidays and show him the love and care that I show him? Maybe that's one of the reasons I shower him with affection now, to try to give him everything that I possibly can now, knowing that when I'm gone, he won't get it. Yet, Brian is taken care of financially. He won't want, but he will want love and affection. He will want love and affection. Where is he going to get it? Where is he going to get it?
This is like a parade.
There's nothing wrong with Brian in my eyes.
Hi, Grandpa.
Nothing at all. He's just a normal person to me. See, other people think he's, you know, there's something wrong with him. But in my eyes, there's nothing wrong with Brian.
Dog wants to go in the camera, too.
Too many people tease Brian now. Too many people do. And I don't like it. So I stick up for him. What can I do? I think a lot of Brian. A lot. I really do. I think a lot of Brian.
A peaceful and happy life for Brian. That's all I can ask for. God will see fit to take care of him, watch over him, and that he doesn't have any heartaches more than he has now.
One day, if he's lucky, Brian may go to a group home for the mentally ill. But there are just 5 in all of Pennsylvania, with just 45 young people living in them. So it's more likely that when Brian's too old for Eastern, he'll be sent to an adult institution.
The hardest part of my day is Sunday when I take him back to school. Knowing that I'm going home to an empty house when Brian should be with me. When Brian should be with me. And I have everything in Brian's room as if he's with me every day. When I go past that bed, I can picture Brian in it. When I'm going to bed at night, I can picture Brian in it. And it hurts. And it hurts. That's when I pray for him.
You know where you're at now, Brian? Brian?
What?
Do you know where you're at now?
School.
That's right. And are you going to be good for Dad?
Yeah.
That's right. All right, let's go. Brian, come on. Catch Linda. God love you. And don't you shake hands with Dad?
Okay. I love you, Dad.
I love you too, honey. I love you a lot.
Okay.
Good night. Good night, honey.
I'm gonna walk him over, Jim.
All right, honey. This is the hardest part of the day. Just bringing him back here, knowing that I won't see him till next week. There's no Brian in the bed upstairs. I can't tell you anymore.